Hello students, I know you all are waiting for my new video. Now today I am going to explain some numerical problems related with dimensional analysis, and these are the important problems based on all the applications of the dimension. Now the first problem is, a position x of a particle depend on time according to the equation x is equal to at plus bt square. Determine the dimension of a and b as well as what are the physical quantity denoted by a and b we have to find out in this question. Now in this question here the value of x is represented as position. It means the dimension of x is nothing but the value is l. The dimension of x is l because x is denoted by the position. If from this equation, if x is l, according to the correctness of equation, this whole term will also be length or position. This whole term also be length or position, right? So to proceed this question, we solve as from equation. X is equal to at plus bt square, right? The dimension of x will be l. Okay, dimension of x will be l. Why? Because x is a position. So if left hand side is a length, so right hand side will also be a length. Okay, hence the dimension of at square, at is also length, and dimension of bt square is also length, right? So at is length and bt square is also a length, and in this question we have to find the constant value a and b, the value of a and b we have to find out. Now how we proceed for value for dimension of a? Right, dimension of a is written as, dimension of a is written as what? The dimension of at, and we divide by time, so it is only the term become a. So dimension of at upon dimension of time, right? So if we divide this term by time is cancelled out, only a is remaining here. So for the dimension of a we have to write the dimension of at upon dimension of time. How it will proceed? Dimension of at is l, dimension of time is t. So final result will be lt minus 1. So the dimension of a will be lt minus 1. The dimension of a will be lt minus 1. And what is the quantity? This is a physical quantity representing the velocity, right? So dimension of it is, dimension of a from here we will get lt minus 1. Dimension of a, what will we find? Lt minus 1. And what is the physical quantity is that? This is nothing but that is a velocity, because the formula of velocity is length upon time or distance upon time. So this is a physical quantity, velocity, and the dimension of a will be lt minus 1. Now for the dimension of b. Okay. Dimension of b. How we proceed? Dimension of b is dimension of bt square upon dimension of t square. Right, dimension of bt square upon dimension of t square, we get the dimension of b. put the values here. Dimension of dt square L, dimension of t square, that is capital T square. The relation is Lt minus 2. And what is the Lt minus 2? The physical quality which is represented, that is acceleration. The physical quantity that it represents, that is the acceleration. So final result, dimension of A, Lt minus 1, dimension of B, Lt minus 2. I am writing here the final result. Dimension of A, what is Lt minus 1, and for physical quantity it represents, that is velocity. Dimension of B, that is Lt minus 2, and what physical quantity is represent? Acceleration. So this is the final answer for this question.
Okay.
Now the next question is, find out the unit and dimension of a constant A and B in the term of equation P plus A upon V square V minus B equal to RT. Okay, in this question we have to find the unit as well as dimension for the constant A and B. Right? In this equation, the P, V and T are defined as pressure, volume and temperature. Here the P is for the pressure, represent the pressure, V represent the volume and T represent the temperature. Okay? One more thing, always remember, the quantities which have same dimensions can be add or subtract. The quantities which have same dimension can be add or subtract. It means in this equation, the dimension of pressure and dimension of A upon V square must be same. So they are add to each other. Similarly, in this equation, the dimension of volume and dimension of B are same, so they are subtract with each other. So always remember, the quantities which have same dimensions always add or subtract. So in how to solve this equation, first of all, in this equation, in the given equation, P plus A by V square V minus B is equal to RT, P, V and T are pressure, volume and temperature. Right? Now, the load point for this question has the quantities which have same dimensions can be add or subtract. Right? This is a note point I am writing here, because from this question we have know one more thing about the dimension, that is if the quantities are same dimensions, then they can only add or subtract. It means the dimension of P is equal to dimension of A upon V square. So we have to find the dimension of A. So for this, dimension of, now we can write as dimension of A upon V square is equal to dimension of P. Right? A upon V square equal to dimension of P. Right? So we have to find the dimension of A. So we can write dimension of A is equal to dimension of P multiplied by dimension of B square. Dimension of B square. Okay. So now put the dimension values here. Dimension of pressure is ML minus 1 T minus 2. This is the dimension of pressure. Dimension of volume square is L to the power 6. Dimension of volume square, dimension of volume is L to the power 3. So square L to the power 6. Now solve this equation. to get the answer for dimension of A. Now the dimension of A will be, dimension of A is what? M L to the power 5 T to the power minus 2. Okay, this is the dimension for A. Now question says, what about the unit? Unit for A, we can write as kilogram, right? Meter to the power 5, second to the power minus 2, right? Or what we can write as? We can write Newton meter to the power 4. How we, I write that? Because 1 Newton is what? 1 Newton is kilogram meter second to the power minus 2. Kilogram meter second to the power minus 2. So kilogram meter second to the power minus 2 is written as Newton, and remaining term is m to the power 4. So answer is Newton meter to the power 4. This is a unit for A, and dimension for A and L to the power 5 T minus 2. Now going to find the dimension and unit for B. Dimension and unit for B. Now for B. Okay. Now what we write is for the B, dimension for B is equal to dimension of capital B, that is volume. So what is the dimension of B? Dimension of B become L to the power 3. Okay, what about unit? Unit of B will be meter cube. Unit of B is meter cube. So this is the solution for this equation, this question, okay? Now the next question, find the dimension of omega and k in the wave equation y is equal to a sine omega t minus kx, where x is a distance and t is a time. So in this question, we have used the procedure here, a sine omega t minus kx, this much is whole is an angle, right? And we all know that angle is dimensionless. So if we find the dimension of omega, dimension of omega, we can write dimension of omega t upon dimension of t. As I told you earlier, dimension of omega t upon dimension of t. Right? What about the dimension of omega t? The omega t whole is an angle. So its dimension is m0, l0, t0. What about the dimension of time? That is t. So our answer is t inverse. Okay? So the dimension of omega is t inverse. The dimension of omega is t inverse. Similarly, dimension of k, we can write dimension of kx upon dimension of x. Okay, kx overall is the angle, so its dimension will be m0, l0, t0, and x is what? X is the distance, so its dimension is l. So our answer is l inverse. So that final answer is dimension of omega is t inverse and dimension of k will be L inverse. Okay. Now in this next question, if the unit of force, energy and velocities are 10 Newton, 100 Joule and 5 meter per second, obtain the unit for length, mass and time. Right? Here the units for the force, energy and velocity are given as 10 Newton, 100 Joule and 5 meter per second. Now to proceed this question, first of all, we have to write these terms in terms of their dimension. Dimension of force. What is the dimension of force? ML minus 2 and its value is given as 10 Newton. We hope this is a equation number 1. Dimension for energy. Is ml square T minus 2, which is given as 100 joule. Equation number 2 assume as. The third is dimension of velocity is LT minus 1, which is given as 5 meter per second. Now we have three equations. The first dimension ml T minus 2 equal to 10 Newton. ML square T minus 2, 100, LT minus 1, 5 meter per second. Okay, now we have to find the units for length, mass and time. So we calculate the values of mass, length and time by the help of these three equations. Now we have to divide equation number 2 by equation number 1. Divide equation 2 by equation 1. What happen? ML square T minus 2 divided by ML T minus 2. 100 upon 10. So M is cancel out. T cancel out. Right? Here we get the value of L as 10 meter. Right? So the dimension of L or value of L will be 10 meter. Now second, put L is equal to 10 meter. In equation 3, we put the L is equal to 10 meter in equation 3. L is equal to 10 meter in equation 3. What it get? LT minus 1 is equal to 5. So, what about the T minus? We can write L upon T is equal to 5. Or what about the T? We can write T is equal to L upon 5. So, T is equal to L upon 5. T is equal to L upon 5. Okay. So T will be 10 upon 5. That is 2 seconds. So here we get the value of T as 2 seconds. Now if we put the value of L and T in equation 1, we get the value of M. Here I am going to write, put values of L and T in equation 1. Now what happened? MLT minus 2 is equal to 10 is given as. Okay. Now we can write ML upon T square is equal to 10. We have to find the value of M. So we write M is equal to 10 into T square upon L. Right. Put the values 10 into T square, that is 4. L is again 10. That is cancel out. The answer is 4 kilogram. So final result, time is 5. The time is 2 second. Length is 10 meter and mass is 4 kilogram. Okay. Now the third question, a very interesting question is this. Because in this question, we have used the two applications of dimensional analysis. One is correctness of dimensional equations and second is establishment of the formula. A body of mass m suspended from an ideal spring is executing simple harmonic oscillation. The force constant of the spring is k and the time period of the body is t. Show by the dimensional method that the formula t is equal to 2 pi m upon k is incorrect. Establish the correct form. Okay, so here first of all we have to check this equation is correct or not. If this equation is not correct, we have to find the correct equation. So to start this question, we have to write the dimension of these physical quantities. Here there are three physical quantities are given: time, mass and spring constant. So the dimension of mass we have to written as capital M, right? Dimension of time period we have to written as capital T. Dimension for spring constant K we have to written as MT minus 2.
This is the dimension of spring constant, Mt minus 2. Now, put the dimensions here and check the equation is correct or not. Dimension of time is t, 2 pi, neglect this because this is a constant value. Dimension of mass, capital M. Dimension of time, spring constant, Mt minus 2. So, M is cancelled out. The result comes t minus 2. Here the left hand side term is t and right hand side term is t minus 2. So equation is incorrect. This is incorrect. So here we find this given equation is incorrect. Now we have to find the correct equation. How we can find the correct equation? We use the third method or third application of dimensional analysis to maintain the correct equation. How we can maintain? We have to establish the formula for time. So we written as time is proportional to mass to the power A and K to the power B. There are two physical quantities, mass and K, mass to the power A and K to the power B. Now equalize this equation by putting a constant K here. This is a K constant and this, I am writing this K is small k, right? No. Here I write the any other term P. P is the constant. I am writing here. Assume P as a constant. Right? P as a constant here. So P to the power M to the power A, K to the power B. Now put the dimensions. What the dimensions we can write here? Mass M to the power A, K, Mt minus 2 to the power B. Now, T, the dimension of time, is equal to mass to the power A plus B, time to the power minus 2B. Okay? Now, equalize the equation as A plus B equal to 0 and minus 2B equal to 1. Right? So, we get B is equal to minus 1 by 2 and A is equal to 1 by 2. So, finally we get B is equal to minus 1 by 2 and A is equal to 1 by 2. Put these constant here. Now you get T is equal to P times mass to the power 1 by 2 and K to the power minus 1 by 2. Or you can write P times under root mass upon K. Right? As in the question given the constant as 2 pi. So you can write this complete equation as 2 pi under root M upon K. 2 pi under root M upon K. This is the correct equation for the time period of simple harmonic oscillation. Okay? Now I am going to take a last question to explain the dimensional analysis, explain the dimensional analysis. The question is given as the speed of sound v in the medium depends on the modulus of volume elasticity e and the density rho of the medium. Obtain the formula for the speed of sound by the dimensional method. Here the factors of the velocity are given as factor on which the velocity depend are given as modulus of elasticity and density. So proceed the question as the factors on which velocity of sound depend are E and rho. So to establish the formula, we can write V proportional to E to the power A and rho to the power B. Now, equalize the equation as constant K, E to the power A, rho to the power B. Where K is what? K is nothing but that is a constant. Okay? Now, we have to write the dimensions of all the quantities. The dimension of V is M0 L T minus 1. M0 L T minus 1 is equal to dimension of elasticity एम एल माइनस वन टी माइनस टू एम एल माइनस वन टी माइनस टू टू द पावर ऑफ ए डायमेंशन ऑफ डेंसिटी एम एल माइनस थ्री टू द पावर ऑफ बी. नाउ इक्वलाइज दिस पावर एज एम टू द पावर ए प्लस बी एल टू द पावर माइनस ए माइनस थ्री बी टी टू द पावर माइनस टू ए. हेयर एम टू द पावर जीरो एल टू द पावर वन एंड टी टू द पावर माइनस वन. नाउ इक्वलाइज द वेरिएबल फॉर फ्रॉम द बोथ साइड वी कैन राइट एज a plus b equal to 0 equation 1 minus a minus 3b equal to 1 equation 2 right and minus 2a equal to minus 1 equation number 3. From this third equation the value of a will be 1 by 2. So we get the value of a 1 by 2. Put this a in equation 1 we get the value b as minus 1 by 2. So here we solve the variable a and b as a equal to 1 by 2 and b is equal to minus 1 by 2. Now put these equations here. We get the final relation v is equal to k e to the power 1 by 2 and rho to the power minus 1 by 2. Or we can write k under root e by rho equal to v. This is the final formula. Right? Here put k is equal to 1, the relation is v is equal to under root e by rho. So final relation we obtained, relation between velocity, elasticity and density v equal to under root e by rho. Okay. Now if you found any problem to solving the dimensional question, write your questions on the comment box. I definitely provide you the solution of that question. But don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you so much.